Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Mr. Chairman, sir, and Royal Father, and please let me write on the protocols has been established. I welcome you all here today. I believe most of us have this program, so let me not bore you by going through the speech that has been prepared here for me. For the students, I'm very sorry if you don't have your copies yet, but every one of you should go home with a copy today. I will go to the last page of this speech, which says, finally, may I once again call on Edo State Government to urgently recruit and draft teachers, especially mathematics teachers, to secondary schools in Esalan. Many of the students who participated in the exams are not here today due to their poor performance in mathematics. The death of teachers in our schools should be addressed as a matter of urgency by the state government. Chapter 2 of the 1999 Constitution of Nigeria, as amended, places a responsibility on government at all levels to provide qualitative education for its citizenry. Our government should be guided by this constitutional provision and give close attention to the education of our youths. Having said that, I am told by my pastor that every child is your child. That is why I have not held back in past years to assist primary school children and secondary school children. So what I have said is that by the grace of God, when elected to the Federal House of Representatives in Abuja, I will get a consulting body to recruit science graduates from this constitution, and then we will send these science graduates to the schools, to the secondary schools, to help the government. And we will pay these science graduates far more than what the government is paying teachers. When we do this, we will begin to churn out quality secondary school students that will take their NECO and will be scoring 99%. That is a promise, and I must do it. It's not enough putting pressure on these young ones. When I was in secondary school, we had a teacher to every subject. And any day the teacher does not turn up, there's another teacher to take that subject. For these young ones today, it's not like that in your case. You have one principal and two teachers. If your principal read English, how is he going to teach geography? How is he going to teach chemistry, mathematics, chemistry? And yet we are blaming the students for not performing well. So on behalf of my generation, I want to apologize to you young ones. I have said, and we all know, America today, we all want to go to America. But America was built by Americans, by individuals, not the government. So I have taken this upon myself and members of my foundation to assist these young ones, like our great man of God, Bishop Okosu, prayed earlier on. My prayer is for you young ones to be greater than me. And how do we do that if we don't help you today to stand firm? I don't want to waste too much time on this today. I would hand over the microphone. I will welcome you all here.